Oh,
so much
I
that
will
we
see,
did.
but not what's being recorded, so I'm not going to say it.
What?
Yeah, tell us later on. I don't think Dragon's recording the chat, so you can say it in there.
I thought recording started.
Yeah,
it did.
Yeah, so good, but she got off topic. Then we started talking 50 Shades of Grey. Then we started talking about My Little Pony. And
Shadow
now we're
Run.
Talking about furries.
Shadowrun!
Yeah, let's get back to Shadowrun before I feel
I
like
shoot everybody in the face with her.
Here's what my character has. It's giving him a 3 straight street cred.
Oh yeah, let's get back to Manga's magic troll.
Yeah.
And all of its magic troll glory.
I told you guys I was recording. Because I thought we were gonna...
I know you did. I that's what I said. I knew you were recording this whole time. That's why I was just like, oh, gee.
Apparently two of our players didn't know we were recording.
Yeah, he told us. I heard.
Okay. Dragon, edit.
Fine.
Hey, cut that out.
I'll leave it in there.
It's not going to come back to me that I pretty much hate them.
Okay, cut here, restart. Because everything we said, was just fucked up.
I don't know.
Well, we all learned something tonight.
Equally bad as when I was playing the game, the elf.
Yeah, nothing tops the elf.
Okay, but
nothing tops that.
Okay. Recording note, edit, cut here. Okay, let's play some Shadowrun.
Yeah, I think we should play some Shadowrun. Let me just sign my notes.
Alright. Fine, I'll edit it.
Also, I mean, I guess we can just forget about that assault rifle I wanted to, or whatever, I think.
You want to buy an assault rifle?
No, the one that I looted from the mafia guy that you said was all... I couldn't use it.
Oh, I did this for Basic, too, and this is... Manga's probably going to be very upset with this. Basic was very upset with this. I made it so, if you've ever played Metal Gear Solid 2, there's a reason why you can't use the terrorist guns. I did that same exact reason for why he couldn't use the guns. And it's sort of the reason why you can't use that gun.
Remember we said I was going to crack...
What's the reason?
Biometric lock.
We said I could crack...
Doesn't have a
single. Those can be hacked.
Yeah, you can take those off.
No, I'm saying that you have
to take
to
the gun apart
manually,
and take it off.
Yeah, you have to manually go in there and get it out and then put a new sample
you can
in yours.
Manually hack. You can either manually remove it or you could hack it.
You
to
can't
change
hack
the biometric. Yes, you can.
I've already talked to Basic about... I already told Basic about this. As I said, I'm using Basic as a test subject for this crap.
Well, okay, I want to hear how
should,
you prevented...
You should just be able to take the biometric system off of the gun. You just have to take the gun apart first.
Yeah, you should be able
Wait,
to.
You don't allow unwired. I bet maybe you could get away with this. If you don't allow unwired... Yeah, you could get away because then you don't have the right type of drones to do this. There's a specialty drone that allows you to connect to anything if you can just get it on the surface. But since you're not allowing unwired, that would actually prevent it.
Until I reconfigure those programming tables, which I haven't had any luck of doing.
The core shadow on rulebook says you can hack guns.
Yeah.
Actually, I think I made their guns. I think the assault. I forget. They were.
Yeah, if they have electronic firing or a smart link.
No, even if they have the biometric, that itself makes it a hackable gun.
Not just that. They said you can have. All guns basically have something in it because you can store files on a gun because it's part of your pad.
Unless they're vintage. If they're vintage or incompatible, no, you can't.
Okay, if it's got biometric,
so
you're
making guns vintage, biometrically locked.
I didn't say that was vintage.
I was like,
I still want the gun, even if I can't use it.
Yeah,
you can
still
sell
it. Whatever.
Probably sell it.
So it's completely unhackable.
I don't think I gave it a
Quiz smart... Cake doesn't want people to be able to hack it. I'm just gonna. If you guys want to argue,
if it did have. If it did have a smart link, I'll say go ahead, but I really don't
think
I would
give this thing a smart link. Is too imbalanced.
If I give this thing a smart link, go ahead, but... Smart
hacking is and isn't unbalanced. If you're
I didn't give this thing a smart link. I didn't even give this thing electronic smart firing.
The thing about hacking is if you have someone who knows how to do a lot of hacking, you need a GM who also knows and can also knows the proper countermeasures.
That's players can abuse hacking pretty badly.
Players can abuse anything if they want to.
Yeah, I had a player where I wasn't keeping tabs of him, and he was I'm not going to say this now. You probably already know of Basic, but I'm not going to say this for my other players because I don't want them using this because I can't figure out the penalties that well.
Just say you can't use it.
I just don't like when players try to hide stuff from the GM.
Yeah, that's a piss off.
And Basic does that kind of a lot.
In our D&D group, there's someone that's been doing that, so when I run the game and he does it, he brings it up by saying, no, you never had that, because you never told me about it.
Yeah, that didn't have any electronic parts. I'm still saying you could probably just open it up. Because honestly, I never gave that thing a signal. I never gave that thing any stats for being hackable.
But you thought he would never shoot a gun, so he didn't have a gun built on his character sheet?
There is a signal rating for a biometric lock.
Yeah, I can't find the firewall or the response.
Or the would system. You like me to find it for you?
I wouldn't hack it anyways. I don't have any hacking skill.
You could get Jay to hack it, but you would have to pay him.
Yeah,
or you can manually just remove it if you have armor skill.
I'll just go to a shop and see if they'd be willing to do it.
Willing to do the actually remove that biometric lock?
The illegal work that wouldn't mind tweaking a Yakuza weapon.
Okay, it would be an average, which means it has a rating 3. Since it doesn't specifically give out one, it would fit under the rating 3 because that's standard signal. Personal electronics, headwear, vehicles, drones, home/business terminals. I would figure a biometric lock would figure under standard personal electronics or headwear.
Not all vehicles start off with free. Military vehicles, especially the Miltech spec ones, actually start 5.5.
I know this
because I've been building something I'm not telling you guys about.
Absolutely.
Yeah. I'm just saying, the device rating is probably a 3, maybe a 4. You just use that 3 as all of its stats.
But then you'd have to plant physical data into it.
That would just be an edit test. Once he's exploited the system, he makes an edit test, switching out the old data for Tia's data. And you
no,
just
I
do
mean
an
that
edit.
There's a physical sample in this gun of someone's DNA.
Oh,
meaning you could actually technically track them if JN killed them with a car.
Oh, well. Okay.
That's different. I didn't know that you had a. I didn't know that there was an actually physical. If there's actually a physical thing that it's directly taking from, that would be hard for it. Technically, he could try to do an override, but that's going to be iffy. He could just permanently.
It wouldn't work that well.
Why don't you try using a hammer?
You may break the gun, but you should be able to open it with. Actually, I'm not sure if you should be able to open it with a screwdriver. I did tell you everything that's on it.
Most guns you can just take apart with just your hands. Like, the majority of it anyways.
And then you won't put back together all the gun parts.
Okay, so for now, let's just leave it. He can't hack it. He could take it into a shop to get it removed. Or he could try to have someone else do a hardware test to get the part removed from it.
And it'd just be armor?
It would actually be a hardware, I believe, not armor. Armor is for
armor.
Again.
It would be armor is for weapons and armor, Manga.
It is for weapons?
Yeah.
I thought that was the hardware skill for weapons.
Oh.
Hardware is on page 127 of Shadow on 4th edition.
Yeah, Jay, it's you said that you may be going in and out because you have to shovel.
Yeah, but I think it's going to die down, so meh right now. I have a snowblower.
You literally have to push that snowblower. I apparently have to shovel. And I have to shovel
earlier.
Yeah.
You want some of mine?
Crap, we're getting off topic again.
Okay. Back to game.
Back to the game. Again, for your... Did you get everything I said for the FNHAR?
Oh, you didn't say what gun it was until just now. FNHAR?
Yeah, I may as well tell you if you say you picked it up.
You just type it out.
I'll just send
this. I mean, honestly, if we were more on top of things, I would have used my firearm skill and figured out what type of gun it was before I picked it up, and I might have just left it. But because it was kind of hectic and last minute, I just said I just grabbed it.
Hey guys, when it says availability, if it has an F or an R, what do I have to do? Do I have to make a roll to try and get it?
I don't understand. I think anyone R might stand for restricted, but I don't know if that actually puts a hamper on R.
Okay, there's cutting in and out, so I didn't hear the question.
R and F. On gear, acquiring them.
Yeah.
Okay. R and F doesn't per se affect how easy or hard it is to get something. In certain cases, it does. But the main thing that determines how hard it is to get something is the availability number. F just means it's illegal. R means it's restricted. So.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so R means that technically, I would say if something's availability 4 or lower, I usually say you can buy it from a shop. So if something's a 4R, if you have a fake license for it, you could probably pick it up. But you'd have to get a fake license for it if it's restricted. If it's an F, that means you can't go to a normal shop. The whole thing is whether or not... Yeah. F and R just determine if it's restricted or illegal.
Yeah. Okay. Cool. Thanks.
Yep. So, otherwise, you just use the main number to tell you how hard it is to get something.
And how hard it is. How do I get a fake license?
It depends which rating. The higher rating, the harder it is to get.
Okay. And is the rating of the license how high availability you can get with it?
No. The rating is for it to hold up against scanners. Most cops carry a rating 2 scanner. Store clerks carry a rating 1 or a rating 2. Special military will probably carry a 3 or 4. 4 is the highest, I think 4 is the highest for scanners. Maybe a 6. I have to go check. Fake licenses, I believe, can go up to 6. I don't know how high the scanners can go. It might also be 6. It's been a while since...
Yeah, there is a table in Spy Games that lists what your fake ID actually says about you.
Yeah.
What a real ID says about you, but...
Yeah. But, okay. That's Spy Games.
I'm not allowing that.
Yeah.
And after Basic told me, you can abuse it.
Right. Oh, God, yes. You can abuse Spy Games.
Anyway.
Oh, thanks.
So, yeah, it's basically an opposed test when you encounter something between your rating and their rating, their scanner. So.
Okay.
It's probably 6 for what each, because I know licenses can go up to 6, so I'm guessing the scanners can also go up to 6. But.
I figured only paramilitary. I figured people like Firewatch would have that. Their checkpoints, either depending on the area, 4 or 5, or the worst area is 6.
Yeah, I would only be very rare. 6 is a very rare. 5 would be the very upper military. 4 would be, well, not would be mid military. 3s would be upper cops, and then 2s would be cops and store owners, and 1 would be store owners also.
Okay, so it's been about over an hour and a half. We haven't started playing yet.
Yes, I know that, Jay. I'm just getting. Actually, I'm just gonna do it now.
Banana shoes.
Do 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 do. Da, 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 da.
That always someone always does that like at my D&D game straight. Someone did that. Phenomena song.
I don't know why, but when you said banana shoes, it came into my head.
It's the number of syllables.
Okay, so...
All right, I'm all set.
It's been a week after your last job.
Mm-hmm.
And it's currently 4 in the morning.
Oh, no.
All of you except Mangar are getting, are, actually all of you are getting a call from what appears to be a guy named Zork.
Holy shit, he's got Gruus! Fine. What?
Alright, I...
Okay, who's answering it, and who's just gonna ignore it because it's 4 in the morning?
I'm working, so I'm awake and available. I can just listen to my work.
Well, my troll doesn't actually have a job, so I'm assuming I'm going to answer it.
I probably am.
Tia, do you have the dice roller up?
I'm talking about Manga and
Dog. Slow.
I'm only talking about Ever. Oh, yeah, you're probably up at this time. Either finishing closing up or.
Okay, Tia, I didn't hear you over Questcake. What did you say?
Yeah, it's up.
Okay.
Wait, your bar's still open, or are you just cleaning up? Closing up?
4 a.m. I would say 2 to 4, I'm getting rid of the deadbeats, and then 4 to 6 is closing. Like, you know, setting the shit up.
Select the chat, Tia. Oh, I could have just used Chummer to do this. It doesn't really matter for... I answer it, surprisingly.
Wait, why are you rolling the answer?
I have a reason. Meh.
He's not alone in his bed.
Yeah, I'm right here next to him.
Okay, and Dragon, I don't know if he's actually going to be mad or he isn't going to answer or something.
I would probably answer it just to yell at him.
All right. Hey, I know it's 4 in the morning, but Isaac said he wanted to meet with you guys in the Matrix. Why he says he has a high-paying job.
Wait, did he say he wants to meet in the Matrix?
Are you asking Zork this, or are you asking me this?
You this, because I didn't hear what you said fully. I was asking.
Yeah,
did
he said Matrix. Let me guess.
Not happening.
Of neural structure.
My guy.
The thing that will cause you to have seizures when you go into the Matrix.
Epilepsy?
Yeah, pretty much epilepsy, but when you go into the Matrix.
My comlink doesn't have any VR way. I can only go into AR.
Let me see.
That was my issue. I can't actually get it in VR. I can only go in AR.
Then go in AR.
Oh, okay. Well, it's a bit different to the... Okay, whatever.
Does Novatech care where... Okay. How do you get into the Matrix?
Comlink.
Just any normal comlink can do?
Any no. normal comlink can get in through AR. You need modifications to get in VR.
Okay.
You'll pretty much be looking at it through a screen or something. But VR, it'd be like you're actually in it.
Okay, so VR, virtual reality, AR, avatar?
Augmented reality.
Okay.
Yeah, basically, which technically what some people like to envision is you have a special pair of Matrix glasses, and when you put those on, you now see the sixth world as like how you'd see through the Matrix with everything that's lighting up that's a node, and you'd see just... That's why Seattle's like called the Green City, is when you look at it through the Matrix, everything's all lit up when you're looking through it through AR.
You could also do that with Image Link, I think.
Okay.
Okay. So, I got a question for this guy. Who are you? How'd you get my number? And, yeah. Who are you? How'd you get my number?
I'm Zork, and Isaac works, and Isaac is probably one of the best hackers in Seattle.
Oh, not for long. I'm logging in. I'm going to have my, let's say, stealth biofeedback filter. Reality filter and, I don't know, browse active.
All right. Who's going in VR? Who's going in AR?
I'm going in VR.
Hey.
He wants to meet right this moment?
Strangely, yes. I don't know why. I even yelled at him for a bit for doing this, but he eventually convinced me to call you guys.
Well, I stop wiping the table and sit on a stool, and I guess I'll try to meet his ass.
I go in through AR.
Do you want to know our VR personas at all, if it matters?
I think it actually does matter. Because it's sort of how you're percepted in the Matrix. That's why I need to know who's going in AR and who's going in VR.
Both AR and VR, you can choose your own image.
Oh, just tell me a general image of... each of you, so I have a note, or even better, a picture.
Yeah, you can find a picture of me pretty easy. Basically,
you see me. You see me as a bear troll, and I have bear arms. From what's it? Damn it, I can't remember the name of the game. God of War. I have the bear arms from God of War on the end of my hands.
So you don't wear sleeves.
So you're wearing bear hands.
Yes, and I'm a bear troll.
Which means you're furry.
I'm just going to use the default, which is like the outline of a person that's glowing.
Alright.
Basically, I want to say, like, think of a faceless Mr. Johnson, or as an easy way to say it, Slender Man.
Yes! Slender Man.
I'm a dancing banana.
With the back...
What?
With the back tentacles.
You're a banana.
I'm the dancing banana. Peanut butter.
It's peanut butter jelly.
Abif, if you want, you could be that skeleton thing in your picture. Or does it have to be humanoid?
No, it can be whatever. You can be a fox.
18-year-old Swedish female, but... Oh, sorry.
You can be whatever you want. You could be a giant walking dildo if you wanted to be.
You could be a car.
Beep, beep, I'm a Jeep.
Yes.
Ooh. Miley.
But yeah, no. I am the Slender Man. That includes his tentacles.
And I forgot what Ab was again since Ab wasn't paying attention. Ab?
He's you.
Yes, I'm you.
Wait, he's me?
No, I'm just joking. I guess I'll just be the default. Because a troll looking like an 18-year-old fetish, a Swedish woman, is kind of twisted. A little bit too twisted.
But you could actually do that, though.
No, Abith, you're trolling on the internet.
Oh, yeah, true. Okay, I'll look like an 18-year-old Swedish woman.
Okay.
My voice is still the same, though. It's still a rough troll voice, but...
Yeah, because you don't have a voice modulator. Might get one.
Okay, so you reach the supposed Matrix meetup point, and mm-hmm. you see... Well, fuck, I put his image... You see a monkey sitting on a table.
Okay.
Okay.
Is there a black dude with an afro with it?
No.
Oh, good. It's not Kane. Oh, God.
Who's Kane?
Never mind. You don't need to know about him.
I really want to know about him now.
No. Nope. I'm not talking. Not talking.
If you're not talking, I'll say that monkey belongs to him.
You don't know anything.
Okay, I think we've gone...
He's a hacker from New York, okay? That's all you need to know.
I think we've gone off
topic enough already. About him later and he'll tell me. Yeah, it's just a monkey.
Who's a good monkey? Who's a good monkey?
You're going to go up to him and say, who's a good monkey? Who's a good
No, that's not what I'm saying to him.
Oh, this is interesting. I'm a dancing banana, and there's a monkey.
There's a monkey. Oh, God. No. Why do I have to remember that? Okay, I now have to chant this out of character. Monkey come to banana! Monkey come to banana!
I have my session notes.
Sorry, I had a memory from high school from a LAN party and someone yelled that out chanting to someone else. Cause someone's name was like Monkey and someone else had a username Banana. And we were playing Halo on a local network, and that happened. And it caused a fit of laughter that left everyone rolling around on the floor for a good 10 to 20 minutes.
Yeah, you basically see this monkey. Is there anything you guys want to do before I do the monkey swing?
I'm going to say, okay, clearly one of us has to change their avatar.
No, you don't have to change your avatar.
No, he's just
it's
saying
speaking. It. The monkey is speaking.
Uh-huh.
Spank the monkey.
Did you just say that in character?
No, I was just joking.
So Zork must have sent you them. Alright. I'm currently having a little problem. You see, I have trucks that usually have shipments. These shipments are for, well, stuff. These shipments keep getting raided. And I sort of want to deter them from ever doing it again. So I was wondering if a day, like as in 8 o'clock tomorrow, you guys could escort it
Where would we develop?
To its destination.
Okay. Will we have to be in the truck? Or?
It would be sort of better if you guys were actually... Actually, yes, you have to be in the trucks.
I think only...
You won't be alone, but there will be... You guys will have to be somewhere in the trucks. Or at least enough to guard the truck. The supply truck.
There's just this one supply truck?
There's... Yeah, there's only one.
I think we can afford to take one car and have it.
Here's the problem. From my reports, is that there's something when they go through, I think it's a certain part of Piplov, they actually start getting shot at with what they thought was an assault cannon. The bad news is probably one of the few ways to get this shipment over is going through it. So that's why we've had to go through it for the past, I don't know, few weeks.
Are you asking us to escort this?
Yes.
I don't think I can handle fighting an assault cannon.
I could probably rig the a certain vehicle so you can control it.
What do you mean?
I could probably rig something so you can actually control the vehicle. Any vehicle you want, that convoy.
But I could just hack in and do that anyway.
I can just give you the codes. It'll make it much easier.
Okay. But how will that help with the assault cannon?
As far as we know, there's probably only one guy. If you can try to find where he is, at least the main general area, I could probably take him from there. Though it's not just him you have to worry about. It's a gang you have to worry about. Along with him, they've sort of been looting them.
Uh-huh.
I'm not telling you to kill the whole entire gang, because I don't know who's doing this. The guards never got an accurate description of them while they're being fired upon.
I think the most...
These guys love to use the buildings, too.
Okay, the most stealthy of us should be going after the autocannon.
That's the thing. I don't know where he is. He could be in any of the buildings.
Anyone here have...
I think it'd be a good idea for us to prematurely go to the hot area and set up a few.
Anyone here good with disguises? Wait.
Why don't we just scan for any signals that might be coming off and just find out where he is?
I've tried that. That hasn't worked.
So he doesn't have a comm link on him then, at least.
He can always be running stealth program.
So, which one of us is good with disguises?
I can try to pose as a gang member, but...
Okay.
I don't need to take that risk if... Let's just say I don't want to be the one taking the risk.
I don't think anyone does.
I'd rather us all go through the convoy than me dress up. And... yeah.
In a couple months, I could do disguises with you, but that's not for a couple months.
I see.
I'm not really good at disguising. Sometimes I can talk my way out of stuff. That's about it.
I don't know many details about the gang, so I couldn't tell you about them. Yeah, and the strangest part is I've had people go and check the areas. There usually is no one around. We've checked the buildings and everything.
They could be wearing They could be wearing a chameleon suit.
You might have somebody leaking the information of your convoys.
Yeah, that's another possibility, having a mole.
Yeah, but there's only a few people who actually know.
And one of them could be a mole.
I can automatically rule out Zork, since he's the only person I have had physical contact with.
Or someone could be watching the meeting, this one here.
I know, but I'm trying to disguise this node. Doing my best to, at least.
Yeah.
Okay, so...
so when do we have to be there? What time? Where exactly? All that crap.
8 p.m., you have to be at the start point.
Does anyone here have a long-range, high-powered rifle so we can take this guy out if we see him?
I have high-ranged, long-powered magic.
One of those, right.
That probably would suffice.
Okay.
I'd sooner toss a bullet to the head, but okay.
Alright, so... isn't that...
I could possibly pick up an assault rifle that would have enough range.
Isn't that...
hit something far away.
Isn't that supply truck only have room for, like, two passengers at most?
Yeah, but there's gonna be a few other things. There's gonna be two armed vehicles going.
Okay.
Don't ask me how I set that up with, the local police force.
What?
Because it's an interesting story.
You want us to work with cops?
I want you to work with Ares. They don't know that you're doing this, but I've told them to leave. I bribed them to leave the convoy alone.
So
you're not working with them. I just bribed them.
No, we can't ride
that convoy.
Right.
I just bribed them. They're probably not gonna. Good. They see the vehicles. They're probably not gonna. They're probably gonna let you through any checkpoint you want to go. They're probably gonna let you through almost any checkpoint. I'm saying almost because the ways around Pitlove apparently are blocked off.
Okay, so yeah. All right.
Fine.
We're all going in.
On a scale of 1 to 10, what is the what's the word I'm looking for?
Difficulty?
How hot is the cargo we're going to carry?
It's going to be drone repair parts and a... let's see. A medium... I think either a medium or small-sized drone. And a revolving hub.
Yeah, I'm surprised you're going through all this just to transport a few things.
This better be true, otherwise
there's
we can always check the back.
One more thing.
What?
Hidden in it is a military small walker drone. And I believe the small walker drone is a Lockheed Archain with its weapon.
How bad is that?
If you want the word on the street of how bad it is, F means illegal, right?
Yeah, F means forbidden.
Forbidden is illegal.
Yes.
For most part. It means it's forbidden for a common person to own it. Military, on the other hand, can actually own illegal gear. Or forbidden gear.
Well, it's a heavily modified Archain, and I sort of need for protection services after someone destroyed the last one.
Hang on. So you need to deliver protection services, but you can't even protect your protection services.
I think we are the protection.
An unfortunate accident with a small turf war, a rocket got fired at it. Didn't see the rocket. I'm lucky my food truck wasn't blown up, though.
Countermeasures, come on! Just load up some... Get countermeasures!
I'll make sure... I made sure to put that on.
We are the countermeasures.
I made sure to put that and some good armor on it this time.
Fucking chaff, yes!
Oh.
If you really want, I can send my Nissan Kota with you guys. That has a light machine gun on it. That thing's armored as all hell. If you want me to have it brought to you guys for the purpose
if
of escort.
If we're potentially having a gang-on-gang assault war, yes.
You're what? Your Nissan what?
You guys will be fighting a gang. You guys may actually be fighting a small chunk of a gang.
Yeah, then yes, I would like a highly armored vehicle with a turret on it.
Well, I have a bulldog step van with a turret.
That probably could work. Is it armed with a weapon or not?
It has body 16 and armor 8.
Yes, but this is the contact providing us with a vehicle to use.
Oh yeah, true. I'd rather.
You gotta remember this.
His vehicle than mine.
The contact is offering us to provide us with a vehicle for us to use. We accept it.
Yeah, true.
Yeah.
Cool.
Okay. So that's one extra vehicle that we can use.
It's not extra. It's a replacement.
He's gonna. Drive it.
Well, my kicker says I'll be there, and I exit the.
I will ride in the giant armored vehicle rather than my car, please.
Okay, but who's gonna actually drive it, and who's gonna operate the turret?
I'm okay at driving.
I have 6 gunnery. If anyone's got better,
my pilot groundcraft is 8.
Someone with gunnery should be probably manning the turret.
Yeah.
No.
Either someone with gunnery or high agility.
I've got gunnery, but it's only 6.
Wait, it depends. What type of turret is it? Is it remote? Is it actually a manually controlled turret, or is it remote controlled?
It's a normal external. Yeah, manual and remote.
Oh, and remote. Okay. So either the hacker would do it, or someone with a really high agility.
I have gunnery at 7, including agility. I don't have any advanced in it, but I do have high enough agility, so it would be 7 dice.
Okay, so you have 7. Hacker, do you have the gunnery skill or not?
I do not have the gunnery skill.
Okay, then it's probably going to be the guy who has the gunnery skill, because then you're only rolling 6 dice, so...
Abbott, what's your...
Yeah, so it's me or Dragon.
What's your agility?
My agility, it's only like 2, I think, but I've got 4 gunnery, so it's 6.
Oh.
Yeah. So, yeah.
So
we're pretty much equal.
Yeah.
You're probably best at throwing grenades and shooting weapons than I am, so you're probably best... using your own weapons.
I
think the big guy, I think he should do it because giant mass of meat and muscles gonna be standing in one place getting shot at while he's shooting.
Okay.
Yeah, that's true. I can take a couple hits.
Okay, so I guess I'll ride with
the convoy. I think that's you, Swedish lady.
I'll ride with the convoy if they stop the truck, then I'll be able to get out and attack them.
Alright. Who's gonna drive this thing?
Well, the hacker already said that he would drive it.
I said I could. I don't know if I'm the best at it, though, out of us.
I can't drive for jack shit unless I'm magicking it up. Which I don't want to do extended driving with magic, so no.
I'm saying pilot ground craft 8. I'm assuming that's all right.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, that's higher than.
For piloting, usually people have a 6. If they're a wheelman, they'll have an 8 to 14. So yeah, you're good.
Right.
If you're a god wheelman, then you have the above 14.
Yeah, no. I don't have anything that high.
They'll be fine.
Hey, I've had someone from our real life group make their character as a face wheel man. It is amazing what they survived because he was such a good wheel man.
All right. Okay, anyhow. So what are we getting paid for this?
Zork did say it was a lot.
That's not a number.
Or a big-ass favor. I don't know what Zork can provide us favor-wise, though. So.
I'm not going into this blind. I need to know what I'm getting out of it, so I don't get screwed later on.
Yeah, we're not risking our lives for some pocket change.
Since it may be it's going to be very difficult, I'm going to say 80k.
Each or split up?
Each.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, that's pretty decent.
I'll do that.
I'm going to ask... I'm going to actually be down and out for a while. Yeah, I'll take the money.
Wait, you're okay. Gonna... Oh, yeah, I remember. You're gonna be down and out for a while.
You still have me for another 2 runs before I go out.
Unless after I say this. It advances 2 weeks.
Unless for some reason you automatically have my stuff somehow come in early, you have 2 more... Or it advances 2 weeks, yeah.
The only way to get stuff early is if you pay more or something.
No, I was like, if Quazcake did something else like that, but yeah. I was saying I wasn't going to do anything to get it earlier. I'm fine waiting.
Hold on.
Yeah. Hold on. What are we holding on to?
I thought it was your mother, but...
Dude. No. No.
No.
Don't do that.
Not cool.
We're all adults here. Mother jokes are nothing.
I know. It's really, it's like...
Okay, so...
It's a sad excuse. If you pull out a your mother, it means you have nothing better to use.
Can we skip ahead to the mission?
Last thing. What?
Can we skip ahead to the mission now? Or?
Yeah.
Oh, someone said they had to wait a minute, so I was...
That was Dragon.
Okay. We're going to do that exact thing.
Oh, and if you ever try to hack into my information again, I will blackhammer the hell out of you while you're asleep.
Looking forward to it.
Yeah. Stay the hell away from my link. And log out.
Right, so what is this vehicle he's providing us with?
He's providing you with a... Nissan Kota. It's a book. It's a food truck from State of the Art 2073.
What book is this from?
State of the Art 2073.
Oh, yeah. No, I can't. Okay. Yeah, that's why I don't have it in here.
Yeah, I did warn you guys. I was going to use things that you can't necessarily use.
That's fine.
I won't go overboard.
No, that's fine. I just wanted to check the stats if I was going to use it, you know.
It's mostly going to be weapons and vehicles, not ammunition or any nanites or things like that. If I hit it, it's going to be probably... Sorry. I'm never going to use it.
Right.
So what does it look like?
I would have to open up State of the Art to find out. So give me a second to see if I have that book even. I just chose it because it was a food truck mounted with an Ares LMG.
It's a food truck?
Oh, yeah. It's a food truck. Okay.
The one of those like restaurant truck things?
Yes.
That's kind of sad.
You want to know what the armor value of it is?
It's on one side, really weak because it's got that opening door or window thing.
That's where the machine gun's mounted.
Oh, it's an ice cream truck.
Yes, the ice cream truck of death.
I wanted to buy one of those, but I couldn't.
Because I think an ice cream truck of death would be absolutely hilarious.
It's in a video game, Sweet Tooth.
Good old Sweet Tooth.
No. Here's what we should play. I adjust a jingle in it to say... I am Ice Cream Man running over. That's what it's got to play whenever we hit the horn.
I don't have a 27 State of the Art. Fuck. Oh, yeah, I'm still looking for this old drone, too.
Oh, you don't have it?
Don't have that or this old drone. I sort of want this old drone, so.
Yeah.
I'm asking Basic Foot. But he hasn't come on.
I have it too. I'll give it to you sometime. I'll get around to giving you this old drone eventually.
Alright.
How many books are there for this thing?
You don't want to know.
Is it
okay? There's actual books produced by the company, and then there are PDFs, which are also, some of them are from the company, and some of them are more fan built. I think, I don't know.
Third party.
Spy Games, I think, is more third party, and so is War.
Is there as much as Rifts had?
How many books did Riff have?
There's probably a good 50. There's probably good, for 4th edition Shadowrun, there's probably a good 30 to 40 total things.
I'm pretty sure Rifts had more.
Yeah. If you start taking stuff from 3rd edition and 2nd edition, which I actually am going to start doing for location-wise, especially the map stuff, because the current 4th edition maps and area stuff that they have...
They suck.
They assume you already know about the third and second,
and they don't add that stuff in, which pisses me off to hell, because it's like there's all this information that you actually have to go back and look through the old stuff because they just assume you know it.
And what about new players? What about new people, right?
Yeah, it's really annoying. Because they reference stuff in the fourth edition books for locations that aren't actually in the books. It's actually back in the third or second editions, or even the first.
So
yeah, they've never referenced the Nan either. Nan, so there's so many books.
The Steel, Torrent, right?
I'll admit, I get most of my books from 4shared.
I don't have a problem with it. I think this company is encouraging people to steal files.
There are some books that you can't find. Like, I know Basics had a very hard time trying to find Romeo, one of the Terror books, which I think is called Romeo and Juliet.
Yeah,
he's an adventure book. Start this, or are we gonna put it off for next week?
We should start. We'll at least get somewhere.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we should at least start.
So we're all getting in the convoy and the armored vehicle, or the Nissan Kona.
Yeah, Nissan Coda. You guys are getting into the Nissan Coda?
I'm going in the convoy.
Or are you going to actually do that modification Jay asked for? God damn it, I tried
to... Well, that would take days, because we don't have time.
Yeah, you guys don't have time. This next convoy is going out.
Yeah, I'm just going to ride in the convoy.
All right. If you're riding anywhere other than the Nissan Kona, I need to know where you are. Either one of the two GMPCs.
What's the armor rating of the GMPCs?
I would have to open my guard driver. Come on, load.
Okay, so should I be riding in the back of the truck or like next to the seat?
Actually, wait, I'd probably be riding in something that has it so I have a good visibility. So whichever vehicle has the greatest visibility, because I don't actually need to actually be able to get a gun out or anything. I just have to see a target to be able to blast it.
Ice cream trucks have a big windshield.
I think Chummer may have just fucked up. Because I can't open it. Hold on, I have to close Chummer and open it again.
Because, man, with the ice cream truck, if that window opens up for the turret, all that area is open.
Well, I'm not using the turret, though, and that changes the lineup. I don't know how he has the turret set up. There's different ways to have a turret set up. You could have it being a roof turret. You could have it being...
I'm pretty sure he set it to side.
Oh, you did? Okay, you had a side turret. Okay.
Side, but it probably would be armored, at least, the turret part. The like little shield, the least.
Is it a hidden turret, or is it an obvious?
When it opens up, the turret comes out. When it opens up, you can actually slide the turret up.
So it's hidden then. Right?
When it isn't open. When it is open, it's completely obvious.
Okay. Well, because you can have the turret so it's kind of always sticking out. That means it was kind of always there. Okay. So it's a side door turret. So it goes out, so it opens up to the side. Yes. Okay. So there'd be some visibility. And the other vehicles are just like normal cars?
Two of them are GMCPRD. I don't know if you know the base body of the GMPCs, but... I had to close my charmer, and now I have to reopen it.
PCs? Is it the GMC, or the...
The military one. It was introduced in Military Spec Tech. the first one, not the second one.
There's the Harpy Scout. No, it's not the Harpy Scout. That's way too expensive. Oh, the MPUV. Okay, the GMC MPUV utility vehicle.
Yeah.
It's about 16,000. Yeah, body 14, armor 6. I'd probably be riding in one of those.
Are you sure?
What else is there to ride in? The main ice cream truck?
That thing has 20 armor. It probably would withstand an assault cannon round.
I would want to ride in whatever has the
package. Yeah, but I want to know what's its visibility, though. Because of the armor, I don't know if you have windows to the sides.
There is no windows to the sides. There's the big fucking turret. Which means you could just drive by and just fire magic.
Yeah, there's windows to the side. Otherwise, I'd be driving in a vehicle that wouldn't draw attention to me, except that it's part of the convoy. Oh, wait. Mines. Fuck it, I'm in the truck. There's the potential for mines.
Wait, 20 is a lot for armor? My car has armor 20.
No.
20's the max without 20... smart.
Yeah.
Oh, mine's smart. Mine's normal.
No, this is normal, but the thing is, guess what its body is?
I don't know.
Let them 14. Guess.
16.
14.
I have to open it up.
It's 14. Wait, no. This is a different vehicle?
Nissan.
The ice cream truck.
Nissan. No, wait.
The food truck.
Yeah, the food truck.
Oh, okay. It's not the... Okay, what's the... Crest Cake, what was the truck called that you were using? For the machine gun turret, the ice cream truck?
The... I have them open, but I'm just opening something else.
Oh, I was just wondering if you knew what the name was, because I'll just look it up quick.
See if there is a food truck.
Yeah, it's body 16, its armor's 20. It's rolling 36 dice for resisting impact.
Oh, the Nissan Coda. Okay. Yeah.
What book is that in? Because I've got state-of-the-art 2063 and it's not in there.
Not 2063, 2073.
Oh, okay.
Actually, I have food truck as part of... Oh, yeah, state-of-the-art, yeah, 2073.
Wait, the food truck is in the convoy, right? The convoy truck is something else entirely. And the food truck And the what?
Yeah, there's the food truck, which has 16 body, and then there are two other GMC utility trucks, which have a body of 14. I don't know if they have any additional armor. If they just have the base armor, they have an armor of 6.
And then there's the convoy, right? Convoy truck.
Oh, those two trucks that I was talking about the second time were the convoy, as I understood. It was a 3-vehicle convoy.
Oh, so the food truck is the actual convoy?
It's a 3-vehicle convoy, right, Quaz?
Yeah, it's a 3-vehicle convoy.
Okay. In the 3-vehicle convoy, you have 2 utility trucks, and then you have the food truck with the machine gun turret.
Okay, so.
Okay, so. So we're all in
okay,
the...
Okay, you guys...
So we're all in the food truck.
Everyone's in the food truck.
Okay.
Sit down and shut up, or I'm turning this thing around.
What's the food truck under? Because I added it to Chama and I can't find it.
It's under
Nissan something.
It's you can either Nissan search Coda. For it in the little search bar over there, or yeah, it's under the trucks category.
Okay, I might have to restart Chama.
Yeah, if you add a new book, you have to restart Chama.
Or just close that character and open it up again.
Really cool character works? I don't know.
Yeah, that works, apparently.
Okay. Oh, cool. Here it is.
Yeah, if you were riding in the DMC MPUV, even though it has a stunner, even though it may have a tiny bit better of a gun that's on top, if you've ever seen it, it doesn't have as much armor as the ice cream truck.
Yeah, did you just give them the basic 6 armor?
I give them 10 armor.
Oh, okay. That's not too bad. I still like the ice cream truck.
I know. The ice cream truck's awesome.
Okay. We should take the forklift. So then we could play that song, he tried to kill me with a forklift.
Actually, wait, there's actually a forklift.
Is everyone actually in the ice cream truck?
Yeah.
Or is there someone else riding in the other cars?
There's actually people riding in the other cars.
What meant of us?
No one else is riding in anywhere else but the ice cream truck.
I will ride in the back other van. I do not believe putting all the eggs in one basket.
Yeah, you do.
The GMC or the actual... or do you just want to surprise people when they actually try to go for the drone?
Oh, there's a drone?
There's an actual
drone. I would want to be wherever the main package is.
Actually, if Jay had the command, he might be able to start up and start wreaking havoc.
I'm not a rigger.
I'd probably start making that drone.
You have the command program. You can still do it.
I was told I couldn't.
Nope, no, you can. Vehicles, yes. Go ahead. I let you do that last session, remember?
I mean, with drones.
Session.
Oh, okay. What you can't do, per se, is... Well, technically, you could jump in. You just probably suck at it.
All drones have the stuff to jump in built in. It's just vehicles that don't.
Yeah, it's... The thing is that you can remote control vehicles or drones. The only thing is jumping in with vehicles you can't do automatically. And I normally don't like jumping into vehicles as a rigger. But that's just me. I hate jumping.
Okay, besides, I'm going to be kind of busy driving this thing anyway.
Okay.
Oh, we weren't ride drivers? Okay.
I'm the driver.
Of the ice cream truck?
I thought I was.
All right.
What's the weapon on the food truck?
It is a Ares MP LMG. It's an arsenal weapon.
It just has that one weapon.
I'll just add it to Chama so that I can look at it while we're playing.
Okay, so we're driving along in the...
You guys get there, you get into the trucks. You guys are actually going to be in the... right near the truck. There's going to be a truck in... There's going to be one of the GMCs in back of you, and there's going to be a GMC after the cargo truck. Or it's more of a deliveries van, but cargo truck.
I thought the ice cream truck was the cargo truck.
No, it wasn't. I didn't say it was the cargo truck. In fact, it would be batch insane if that was the cargo truck. He said it was for support.
I thought one of the GMCs were the cargo trucks, and the ice cream truck, was just our support.
There was going to be... I should have told you how many cars there was going to be. Originally, if you guys didn't bring anything, there was going to be 3 cars.
Oh, I thought it was 2 GMCs. There's 2 GMCs, an ice cream truck, and a cargo truck then?
Yeah.
So 4 vehicles total then. There we go.
So all the cargo is in the cargo truck. I'm riding in the cargo truck then.
You're gonna hide in the cargo truck.
Yeah.
Sorry, what did you say the weapon was again on the turret?
The turret was, you know, that little food thing that opens up, the yep. thing that they serve food with. That's where the machine gun is.
Yeah,
and it's somewhat protected. Too.
And what is it? An Ares something?
An Ares MP LMG.
Oh, cool. Yep, there it is. Sweet. Just so I can track the ammo remaining and all that crap.
Since it is manual, you get to use your gunnery skill, so... Yeah.
Are there NPCs in the cargo truck?
There's only two of them driving. There's no one else back there.
Okay. I'll ride in the back then. And chit-chat with the drivers.
All right, so you guys are now finally getting along, and I'm assuming you guys are gonna go the. You guys are you guys gonna try to find a way to get around it, or you're gonna try to go through it?
Probably go around. What do you
guys? Going to do your best to see if there is a way to go around.
Okay, are we talking about the checkpoint or the gang controlled area?
Predetermined. The gang controlled area.
Alright.
I thought the whole point of this was to teach the raiders a lesson.
No, it was basically get
get the cargo through? Okay. Then why don't we just go around it then?
Yeah, if we can find a way to go to more. And you said Ares would not stop us, but would they stop the people attacking us?
They probably would, but then again, you have to go through Piplov. And I don't know if you know that, but depending on where you go in that area, there's lava. So if you go around it, you may run into lava.
What?
Where are we driving from?
You guys are driving from... a base near... Like, I think somewhere... Actually, I don't know where the map is. Oh, yeah, you're driving it from a place outside the edge of Pitlove.
Of Pitlove? I don't think I know where that is.
It's the second worst, besides the Redmond Barrens. It has as I said, there's lava, flats, and... I think it's home to Loveland, I'm not sure. I would have to look at my 27. I would have to look at something special.
Oh, okay. So, what part of Seattle is it in? I should have probably asked that.
It's actually a city.
Oh, it's a city.
It's actually a part of the Seattle.
Oh, yeah, okay. It's a part of Seattle, but is it part of downtown Bellevue? That's what I was trying to figure out. Tacoma.
Keep going.
There's Tacoma, Everett, Renton, Auburn, Snohomish. I might be pronouncing that wrong. Fort Lewis, Redmond, Polyup.
Yeah, maybe that's Polyup.
Oh, okay. That's it. Okay.
Let me see if I can get a map of this. Yeah, it's home to the famous Hell's Kitchen. Which is actually lava.
Yes, the spectacular lava fields. Okay.
But thankfully, if you follow the main 161, you should be able to get through unscathed. At least that's what he said. Oh, yeah, just one more thing. I should have really mentioned this. If that cargo gets destroyed, you sort of forfeit your payment. So protecting the cargo is the first priority. Get destroyed, captured. You have to protect that cargo. That's your first priority.
Yeah. Makes sense. Because if it gets fucked up, we failed the job.
Yes.
So, anything happen? Or...
Well, he's not saying anything, so I guess we're not getting shot at. We get through. We're done.
Yay.
Not necessarily. You come up to a certain spot. You come up to a certain spot. And then... Is anyone in the first GMC?
Nope.
Well, GMC is about to have a very bad day.
That's why I wasn't in the first GMC.
You actually see the, for an assault cannon with AV rounds, would it be possible for... Would it be possible to actually shoot something and the whole entire car would explode?
Yes and no. You could probably do a powerful enough missile, but I don't see a street gang having something. You could for it to be a complete incineration. That's what you're going for?
No, I'm just having it explode with AV rounds.
I would say if you'd have, like, two or three missiles shot at it at once, you could probably say that without doing the rolls. So, you can say we saw three missiles.
What about having an assault cannon try to stop it?
An assault cannon? I'm going to say about the same as the missiles. You're going to probably need probably 4 to 6, though, assault cannon shots. It depends which assault cannon, and yeah, it depends which assault cannon. If you're using the $20,000 assault cannon, then maybe you could pull it off, but that's a pretty expensive piece of hardware.
Eh,
I don't.
DMs can automatic success.
Yeah, I guess you could say. Story purposes, you could have automatic success. Sure.
Actually, I thought of something even cooler. You see it. Whoever can actually see this, i.e. not Dragon Trainer, can actually see that thing skid. Actually, apparently what you see, the driver gets shot and his head gets blown off. And the truck starts skidding and it crashes into one of the buildings.
Did I hear this?
Yeah, you hear that. You hear sounds like a shot and the vehicle skidding and crashing.
I'm going to stick my...
Looks like it slammed into a building.
I'm going to stick my head to the front part of the truck and ask the driver, what just happened?
Keep going. We're getting ambushed. Keep going.
Alright, I guess I'm gonna...
Just keep swimming.
I'm gonna open the window to let the turret out.
Can I do something here?
Yes.
After saying that, I might want to get in the back and drive and pilot the car with my comlink or something.
Yeah. I'm assuming Isaac gave you the code, so...
I'm not sitting up there. Fuck that shit. AR pilot. I believe. Or do I need to do some rolls? If you gave me the codes, you know?
You don't have to make rolls to get into it. Do you have to make rolls if once you start dodging stuff?
Yeah, okay. Once you start trying to dodge the assault.
Oh, wait, I don't have the pilot program. I don't have the pilot program.
You don't need the pilot program. You just need command. Or you could be jumped in. You could just use command.
Okay, command, because I don't understand jump in.
Yeah, I'll actually figure out which is the best way for you to access it. Give me a sec.
Because
It's probably command, but I'll check.
Does the vehicle have rigor adaption?
Oh, yeah, the vehicle probably doesn't have even rigor adaption anyway.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, let's see. Yeah, I would say just use command, because basically you're just using your command plus any other skill, plus your vehicle skill.
Pilot?
No, not pilot. Your vehicle skill.
That's called pilot groundcraft.
Oh, pilot groundcraft, yes. Sorry. I'm thinking the program. If you just say pilot, I think program.
My bad.
Just say groundcraft for the vehicle skill. Don't say pilot.
Okay, because with my program, it's exactly the same as my skill normally.
I think the skill's called maneuver groundcraft.
No, it's pilot groundcraft. That's what I've got here. I'm looking at it.
It is. On Chummer, it's called pilot. I'm not sure. But by the way, when you use it, if you're remote controlling, you take whatever your command program is. If it's 5, you take 5 dice from that. And then you take your skill level, not the dice pool, the skill level. And you add that to your command. Just making sure.
And for what I have, it's exactly the same as my pilot groundcast skill pool. And dice pool is the same.
Yeah.
They're both equal to 8.
Okay. Oh, yes. What was I doing?
So either way, it doesn't matter for me. It's the same thing.
Oh, yes. I'm making a perception test to see where the shots were fired and just overall just to see what's going on, to see where the enemies are coming from.
It looks like a building generally north.
I glitch.
You don't see jack shit.
Wait, I don't glitch. I critically glitch.
You don't see jack shit. In fact, you can't even identify the shots. You can only figure out.
It looks like a sunny day.
You see the thing explode, and you're like, what the hell? What? You're not paying attention.
I just like, huh? Interesting. Well, let's just continue on.
Omega, you tried focusing so hard that you went bloodshot. Like, what's that? Ow, my eye.
Okay, here's his eye. Oh no, call an ambulance.
I could.
Alright.
Oh, they wouldn't come. Ambulance. Omega, you got an eyelash in your eye when you're trying to focus. How's that?
Meh.
What's that? Whatever. He said you didn't notice. Okay. Yes. So he has bacon fries.
Damn it. Stop talking about bacon. I'm going to want to eat my other omelet that I made.
But pickled bacon.
You made an omelet?
I made multiple omelets. One for breakfast today, and then one for breakfast tomorrow.
I'm gonna.
Before you know it's gross. Think about this. What would pickled bacon be like?
Okay, back to Shadowrun. Enough about food.
Okay,
Shadowrun. We've already wasted too much time.
I look around the convoy truck for like a place to stick my head out of and look around.
Like, you could probably stick it out of the back.
Like, there's no sunroof or.
No.
Okay.
No.
Alright, I'm gonna look out the back and see where the shots are coming from. Where. Yeah. Can I do that? Or just look around for enemies?
Yeah, you can. You can do that.
Can't believe I keep forgetting what my perception is. Perception 14. 14d6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 hits. That's him.
All right. Do you see him? You notice that it is dark in those buildings.
Uh-huh.
The muzzle flash may have given them away, but... yeah. The thing about that one is you weren't looking. So you're looking now, trying to find where the shots came from.
Mm-hmm.
Is probably going to be very hard. So I'm going to say you don't succeed.
I don't know.
Look at the thermal vision and see if I could see heated barrel.
Yeah, I think my...
I also have vision magnification, too.
I have thermal graphic.
Quick question.
Let him see heat signature.
You want me to roll perception, or you just want to...
How much does thermal reduction for a barrel do for negatives?
It's negative 3.
Negative 3, plus his thermal dampening 6.
If he has all that, I'm not going to see him.
Yeah.
He could still see the gun. It was an assault cannon.
Yeah.
Could have had thermal.
Those fire pretty hot. Thermal
suppression.
Yeah, that's only a negative 3. I don't know what your perception is normally, but...
yeah, he kind of also has something else relaying the thermal.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's a ridiculous roll. It's not gonna happen.
Okay, I'm just gonna keep a look. I'm just gonna keep looking out the back.
If he fires another shot, he's gotten what he wants. The convoy's probably stopped by now, is it?
I don't know. Did the convoy actually have to stop, or were we able to?
Which way did the convoy turn off the road?
I thought the driver said keep going.
Yeah, I thought we just drove around the blown-up vehicle and kept on moving.
Okay, you guys, the main truck turns around the block. And I'm assuming you guys are going too.
But if that's the main truck, he's got the cargo we need.
You guys want to prevent, so what you actually see what appears to be one of the GMCs actually trying to move up to protect it. However, when it gets to... when it's moving up, it goes past you guys. Another shot happens.
Motherfuck.
Who's paying attention to this shot this time?
I want to look through my turret and see if I can find any heat signatures with thermal vision.
It's a ridiculous test.
Yeah, and I've got 5 perception, so I probably won't.
Well, if he's looking at thermal vision, the muzzle flash will be pretty obvious.
Yeah, you notice that. Actually, I'm not sure if he can notice just straight in front of him with that turret.
Okay, this time I can see it. This time I've seen it, right?
Yeah, if people were actively looking for something and they had thermo, they would see... probably the muzzle flash.
I got 3 hits.
A muzzle flash comes from a
gun.
Small explosion.
Seemed to have come from the 4th floor.
Oh.
I got 7 hits.
Of the building in front of you guys. I didn't describe what the shot did to the vehicle.
Oh.
Would I even be
it
able
basically
to see it?
It basically shot one of the tires. And it goes, actually shoots, no, it wouldn't shoot one of the tires to do this effect. It basically shot the engine block. causing the vehicle to come to a complete and utter stop.
Wait, it shot the convoy? And the GM?
No, it shot the GMPCU.
Okay.
No, a convoy is not one vehicle. Convoy is a name for multiple vehicles working together.
Okay.
Yeah, and this is what it is. Multiple vehicles trying to work together, yet working horribly together.
It's a truck version of a wagon truck.
I
have a question, Quaz. Because I critically glitched, do I notice this set of shots or not?
Could you critically glitch? No.
I didn't think so. I was just checking. I assumed
you're still
not.
Derp.
So until someone informs me.
You're still derp at this point.
Derp.
Herp derp.
I got 7 hits on my perception this time. Did I see them?
Yeah, you know. You also noticed the fourth floor.
Looking at your
floor.
Shoes.
I want to start shooting at that fourth floor if I can. Like if the turret's pointed in that direction.
I'm going to say no. You would have to actually manually turn the gun. You'd have to manually turn the vehicle so it's laying in front of this, covering a small portion of the street, and then fire in front of the building.
That's the problem with side turrets that only point out one way.
I'm not sure how difficult it would be to fire at it.
It's a turret. He should have about 180 degree range of fire, about. So maybe limited to about 160. But yeah, one side.
So
I tell the pilot about where the shot's coming from. I suggest that he turns the vehicle around, and that will be Jay.
What is our current speed?
20 miles an hour.
That's it. All right.
And how far away is this building?
I'm going to say 40 meters away.
That's it?
That's not even an acre paddock away.
I could probably shoot it from here.
No, actually, your van's turned, so you might be able to shoot it.
That's actually barely out of the pistol firing range. So, yeah, anyone could shoot at it.
Okay, so I'm going to broadside the van so he can shoot at it.
Here's the thing. Shooting at it will be a task in its own. Because it is a window.
Then again, do we want to to shoot at it?
I believe it's a negative two modifier.
Yeah, you guys would get a negative two modifier.
Even then, it's a turn. It'd at least be suppressing fire. He'd be less likely to poke his head out.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll use suppressing fire on the fourth floor window.
Suppressing fire, alright. So make your roll. I think it's either gunnery or heavy weapons.
I don't know the rules of suppressing fire, so you'd have to look those up.
Alright, suppressing fire. I've been waiting for someone to use suppressing fire. In fact, I was considering using suppressing fire myself. But we're going to find out now.
Do I need to do a pilot roll or a ground craft roll?
Not you. I think he has to make either a gunnery or heavy weapons skill. I know suppressing fire actually does have a lot of recoil, though. That's all I know.
To get the van in position so he can fire it at it.
Yeah, suppress the fire is meant so they don't want to get out of their cover and shoot back at you.
That's the real beauty of suppressive fire.
It's basically spray and pray.
Yep. There's also the sixth round in case you don't have... The bursts are probably my favorite. You want to know why the bursts are my favorite? You want to know why the narrow is my favorite? Because it adds a plus to your... You have one for your main shot, then add every other DV for your shot. So if you had a full burst, they use 10 bullets. That means you would have plus 9 DV if you can handle the recoil.
Okay, well, we...
But it's hilarious. The thing is, you have to count that it may be cutting to stun damage. But the beauty about these are you could basically attack multiple targets, I think, full.
I believe there is still a negative modifier, but it's not as bad. I think you still have the negative one modifier for attacking multiple targets.
It's not a multiple target, but... Oh yeah, we're going off something else's rules. Sometimes a character may just want use full auto to make his opponents keep it their heads down. This type of shooting when a character... Suppressive fire takes a complex action, uses 20 bullets. The area remains suppressed until the next character's shooting next phase. Suppressing fire is treated as a wide burst, but for simplicity, we'll assume that the wide burst and recoil modifier is canceled out.
Do I need to make a roll for it?
The character lying down suppressing fire simply makes a success test using agility plus appropriate firearm skill. Note any hits. The character that is currently in the suppressed area, but not behind cover or prone, wherever moves into or out of the area before the shooter's next phase, risk catching some flying lead. This guy has to make a reaction plus dodge test plus edge test.
Or one of those stray bolts is going to fucking hit him.
With a threshold equal to the number of hits by the suppressing attacker. If the test fails, the character's hit, suffering the damage from the base damage value.
Alright, so that's three hits.
Characters who do not move remain behind full cover or simply drop prone are not at risk. From the shot, I'm gonna say this. How many hits did Dragon Trainer get?
Dragon. Abin.
Dragon.
What?
He got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
I thought that was for perception. Dragon Trainer looking
at
something.
Yeah, I should have told you this. Since I do have this in my notes. This guy, you notice that the shot, he doesn't seem to be standing up with the gun.
So it's turret based. Or lying down.
Yeah, you could still roll that. You could still roll that test, Abath.
He did.
He did.
Three hits.
You only have six gunnery. No. Okay.
Yep.
Wait. Are we?
I do you the bearer of bad news, but this guy's prone.
Well, it's fine. That means he can't really poke up to shoot, though.
As long as he can't shoot back at us, it's all gravy.
He's not at risk.
I'm thinking about throwing a grenade at him, though. A flashbang.
Okay, I'll say something, Kaz. If he was completely prone, he couldn't shoot anyway, because that means he'd be shooting at the wall in front of him rather than through the window.
Yeah, how would he shoot out of a window if he's prone?
Unless he shot and then dropped prone.
The bastard using cover, yes.
Because
the suppressive fire will make it if he tries to go back and make another shot. He has to roll against Abbott's suppression fire.
Yeah, that's what he has to do. So I have to keep note of free net hits till the next phase when he gets to roll again.
Yeah.
If he fails that, he's probably fucking dead.
Depends on what gun it is. Damage. And then, it seems like out of two of the buildings, three guys each come out.
Okay.
And Abath actually sees them come out into the supposedly, Abath only sees three of them, but Dragon, if you're looking at the front of the car, you actually see three more start walking forward to the vehicle.
Walking?
Actually, I should say running. they're running for the
is
front,
the vehicle
and then there's three guys
still going.
At this point, it's sort of stopped.
I'll say to the driver, why aren't we moving?
The driver sort of kind of froze up.
I'm going to run up to the front and tell the driver to keep driving. Keep going. Run him over.
There's also guys approaching you from the back, too.
Yeah, isn't Dragon in the vehicle that the engine was shot out?
No, he wasn't.
No, that was the very first vehicle.
Oh, I thought the first one was the one that had the guy with his head blown off.
Yeah.
Yeah, the first one, the guy died, and then the second one got the engine shot, and then Dragon's in the last one, I think.
In the pond.
Oh, I thought it was just us and two others for the escort.
I'm in the cargo truck.
Oh, yeah. Right.
So I'm going to go.
Oh, yeah, I wanted to be in the vehicle with the package, too, but I said it like three times and never got a response.
So we have two people in the cargo. Oh, I thought Dragon was going to be shooting the turret.
No. That's Abbas.
Oh, that's the giant troll. Speaking of giant trolls. Actually, I should have you guys roll. Actually, it says here a few combat initiatives. So, speaking of giant trolls, I'm just hoping Abbas is a giant troll.
How many people do we have in this run? Four?
Five.
Hi.
Oh, okay. There we go. That's what messed me up. There's five people. Okay.
I'm so glad if someone gets hit, I have first aid.
You finally have first aid, Jay.
I had it since the start.
Did you buy any Save Your Medical kits?
No.
Good,
because
you don't let banned them.
I unbanned them. What are you talking about?
You unbanded them?
Yeah, I told you I unbanded them last session.
Oh. I didn't hear that part.
So the most I could do was rip someone's clothes so you make bandages.
Probably. Depending on skill.
Stop us from bleeding out, most likely.
My first aid skill, like the full pool, is at 11.
Damn! Jay. Why are you a hacker if you have a pool of 11?
First aid uses logic. Hackers usually have a higher logic, so.
That, in order to the paranoia, in case I get hit, I took some medical training.
I've got a med kit. Need it, anyway.
So you're providing suppressive fire.
Yep. And then so these six dudes come out, but I only see three.
You only see three. Everyone roll initiative. I'm treating these guys as grunts, so these guys have an initiative of 7.
Have I been made aware of combat?
Oh yeah, because he had his glitch.
So yeah, are you in the ice cream truck?
No, I'm not. I'm in the back GMC.
Guys?
Yeah.
Unless someone sent me a comlink message, or if the GM says I'm notified, yeah. That's what I'm asking. Until the GM tells me otherwise, I don't know anything.
Kaz is losing the call, and Tiamat just dropped.
Oh, okay.
I'm guessing it was because Tia was downloading stuff, and I don't know.
Yeah, probably the torrents.
All right. I'm sorry about that. We've lost the duck.
The duck?
Yes, I'm referring to Tia as a duck.
Okay.
Don't know why. I feel like it. And that's why sort of use counting. But it's just a fun thing. Okay, so Mega roll, could you load up the dice roller?
Timo's
offline.
It'll take me a while. I have to pull Skype.
How long is a while?
1 to 5 minutes. I have to pull up Skype on my computer.
Well, that gives me time to pee.
Yes, Jay, that gives you time to pee.
Anyway, so how many vehicles in the convoy? We've got the ice cream truck and the cargo truck and the two vehicles that got shot. And
I like to say that one of the vehicles is currently operational. It's just that it can only use its turret. So I'm going to say it gets to use its skill. So
the one that got shot, is that the one that Ming is in?
No, I'm in the very back.
None of the vehicles guys are in are getting shot yet. And so the keyword being yet.
So there's three GMCs.
Two GMCs. Two GMCs, then what's the vehicle Ming is in? Hermes delivery van. The food truck, and that's it. Oh, there's two. There was two instead of one. GM, MPVCs, whatever they're called.
Okay, so there's four trucks. I mean, four vehicles in total. Besides the one that got exploded. Oh well, they got the driver murdered. We're trying to figure out where Manga's character is.
Manga's character, he's in the food truck.
Oh, I'm in the back GMC. Back GMC.
Yeah, I should have had you.
I have a control.
I thought it went GMC.
I thought the back GMC went to help the cargo truck. And then
Manga currently notices that the driver seems actually hurt, but the actual gunner the actual gunner got killed, but the driver is actually pretty wounded, so someone has to take up the responsibilities of using the turret. But since you're a troll, I'm going to say that you survived that pretty unscathed.
The Mingi's a troll too?
Okay. Yes.
I'm confused.
So am I.
Talk to us.
Okay. I was in the back GMC, the one that was behind in the very back of the convoy.
It went up to help the convoy. But yet got absolutely screwed when trying to do so.
The second GMC is the one where the engine got shot, right?
It's not the engine.
Okay. Sorry, someone came in. Okay, what's going on? I thought I was in the GMC at the very back of the convoy.
I thought there were only two GMCs.
Yes.
Yeah.
The one in the lead, the driver got shot in the face. The one in the back got shot and it stopped.
Is that what happened? I thought that was the ice cream truck that got shot and stopped.
No, it didn't. Because the one in the back drove forward to try to cover the front one.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to do, but it failed. I'm assuming you weren't the gunner.
I don't think Mega.
I'm assuming that you were just a passenger.
Of the ice cream truck or the GMC?
The GMC, the back GMC.
That had a gunner on it?
Both of them did.
Oh, I didn't know the GMCs had gunner. I thought that was just the ice cream truck. Yeah, I was just a passenger on the GMC. I didn't realize the GMC was moving forward. Or changed position. I thought we were still at the back of the convoy. I thought that was the ice cream truck moving into position.
Makes sense since you glitched.
Look, yeah. Ice cream.
The well, ice now cream you truck notice. Into
position after the GMC got shot.
And right now it's broadsiding with, so Abath can shoot at the building.
Okay. Even though I critically glitched, I think I would have asked why we went out of formation position, because that would be a bit weird.
I also have
you
a question.
You should have actually asked that when the truck was moving up.
I thought that was the ice cream truck you were talking about, not mine.
If it was the ice cream truck, I wouldn't have said that they could move 180 degrees.
Okay, look, confusion happens. Relax.
Yeah, I know. It's a pretty big convoy.
Yeah, there was a lot of things going on, so I did not understand what vehicles were being talked about. Okay, I want to say that I am now aware of combat, because that would have ended up me becoming aware.
Okay. I do have a question, though. Kaz?
Yeah?
You said roll initiative. I've never had to do that before, so what do I do?
Your initiative score? Your initiative?
It's 6 bracket 7. What do I do?
Roll 7. 76.
No, okay. It should be. Are you sure, or is it the 6?
It's the 6? Augmented one.
Yeah. Oh,
in most
okay.
Situations, the one in it's the augmented one.
Yeah, the one in the bracket.
Oh, I get it. Yeah, reaction plus int plus modifiers. Yeah.
What happened to Timu? Did he come offline, then go offline?
It dropped. I think it fucked up for him.
You want me to try adding him back in? Oh,
try to re-add him. Yes.
I'm trying to do something here.
Dice roller's up.
Okay.
Okay, so who's rolling what?
I think we're all rolling initiative. Oh, wow, I only got one hit on 76. Does that mean I glitched?
How many ones do you have?
Two.
No. Nope, you're fine.
Does it have to be at least half?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so you take...
Is it rounded up or rounded down?
Okay, so you take the number of hits you have and add it to your initiative. So your initiative is 8.
What? So one hit, I have initiative 8. Okay.
Dragon, what's your initiative so I know how much you're rolling?
2.
Then, what do initiative passes mean then? Because I have 2.
That's how many actions you have during an initiative round.
That's how many actions I can make in a round?
Yes. Or, well, how many turns do you have in a combat round?
Okay, so I have 2 turns.
Yes.
Yeah.
I don't know what I would do, though. Probably...
Attack faster? Okay, so I have...
Manga, you glitched again.
No, I didn't. It's only 4, not 5. Nah.
Yeah, you can probably drive the ice cream truck around.
I didn't glitch.
I'm reading 3D4 for you.
Oh, that was me testing to check the roll if the roller was up.
Because I kind of didn't want to drive forward because I didn't want to fuck up your
84.
Yeah, fair enough.
Yeah.
Quiz cake. Abish has 11.
Yeah, I was rolling D4s, not D6s. That should tip you out that it wasn't a real roll.
So
Jay has 8 initiative.
My initiative is only 8.
9, 10, 11.
I'm guessing 8 is pretty
12,
terrible, 13, right?
13, 14, 15. Dragon Turner has 15 initiative.
Yep.
So, what, we add.
Manga has
we roll all the number of dice in those brackets, and then we add the number of hits to that number?
Yeah, I think so, yes.
Yes.
Yeah, Manga was Manga now has 11.
If you look at my roll, you'll see that I rolled 9 dice, and I got 2 hits, and you'll see me type my final number being 11-1, which means my... Okay. Yeah.
Everyone type your total number so I can keep it somewhere.
So I typed down 8.
Type down 8 and how many initiative passes you have after it. So 8/2.
Everyone but Mang. Oh, god damn it.
What?
We're having problems with call again.
Tiamat's dropping again.
I know, Jay.
And someone's playing a video game. Someone's playing Dungeon Defenders.
Manga. Yes. You know, I can't be mad at this because I would do the same thing.
Yes, you would.
No, I wouldn't.
I am
Dungeon Defenders takes almost no mind power to play.
I am tempted to load up an emulator and play Shadowrun for the Sega.
If it didn't cost too much CPU, I'd probably be playing either Tap or Quake right now because I'm really...
Don't you do it. Quake. Don't you do it.
Oh, I
kind of
want to... But
I'm the GM.
I kind of now
want to
pull out Quake Wars for Xbox now.
I actually lost access to my first Steam account one time after the... what I like to call the Quake Wars incident. Because apparently I got my account suspended. I don't know how, but I did. It wasn't until 2010, 2011, when I finally was able to get back to a normal working status. And Dragon, that's the one I was usually using, not the one I'm using now.
Did you touch someone on the bum? Is that why you got suspended?
No.
Then why'd you get suspended?
I don't know. To this day, I don't know. They never, Steam never tells you when you get banned. Never tells you what you've been banned for.
You can actually ask. I've had someone ask and get an answer before.
Yeah, it should be in customer support, shouldn't it?
That's actually really uncommon. They've even stated, if you've been suspended, they don't tell you why. And if you've been back banned, they don't tell you why.
But you can ask.
You can ask, but they won't tell you.
You could try.
Did you check the server that you were last on? Because it might have been a hacked server or something.
It was Quake Wars, the demo for Quake Wars on the PC. But I did eventually get the account back. I did have to show I actually owned some Steam games, so luckily I wasn't using that key anymore, but...
Yeah, maybe that key was illegal for the demo.
I don't know. Could have been anything. Oh, we're getting off track again. Damn it.
Yeah, okay. Get Tiamat back here.
So,
you guys want to do this about Tiamat, or you want to call it?
Kind of want to play online? Here. I mean, we're here.
Should we try adding him to the call again?
If he's...
Yes, keep adding him to the call. Keep trying.
He's online again,
While we're trying, why don't we just write into the chat what's happening so we can still keep up?
Okay. Alright, so I still have one more... I still have to roll 76 for these guys. Actually, I get to do it... Actually, since... No, I don't get to do it. 76... The grunts, and I'm using the grunt rolls for these guys, are 1, 2, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So,
how far away are they?
They're closing in.
Are they close enough that I can charge them?
Have you gotten out of the vehicle yet?
No. I can go out the back.
Well, we said that.
I just realized we're not gonna finish combat. I just realized that because 30 minutes. Like, I still have to go at like 10:50 since I don't know if I can stay up.
You're a big boy.
No, I risk getting my internet cut off.
Fine, you're not a big boy. You're a child.
I know.
Yeah, I would just say save this for next time. Combat's going to take quite a bit of time, probably.
Especially since I may have I accidentally mentioned the troll.
Yeah, I don't know how many things you have for us to fight against, so if you have more than probably 5 opponents, then it's going to take a longer than a half an hour, probably.
Yeah. I'm sadly going to call it here.
Well, the best way to make a combat go is to hack into a car and have it run over like a few people at a time.
But then you have to deal with more gang reinforcements. Combat's probably going to take up the bulk of the next session. Depending on how much you guys... Depending if you guys just want to scoot out of there or fight everyone.
I don't go out. I do not go out.
I'm still telling you, Jay, you should hack that walker drone. Because I would really love to try to use one of those.
He doesn't have the vehicle skill for it, does he?
He doesn't have anthropomorphic, does he?
No.
Yeah, that's what I was pointing out. If he doesn't have the vehicle skill, he can't use it because you can't default on that vehicle skill.
Oh.
Yeah, you can only default on groundcraft and watercraft. You can't default on aircraft or the walker drones, which is the anthropomorphic. So yeah, if he doesn't have the vehicle skill, he can't operate it.
I don't know why everyone considers weapons from war to be so BS.
It's just mainly the battle rifles and some other rules.
Well, you could fix the battle rifles by saying you can't put fully automatic on them. They're done. Fixed.
Kind of, but you can always modify them then. Or are you just saying fully no modifications allowed? Because it's kind of like a eh.
No fully automatic. If you know the slash FA, I don't think any of the battle rifles have slash FA, so no.
Actually, they do.
I would say the downside to us calling it now is means we can't do stuff during the week because we're kind of in the, in this combat.
Yeah, that's the only bad time. Well, at least it's our first two-part session. I'm going to give us that.
Still, yeah, I was hoping actually...
First two-part session.
Yeah.
What about the first, very first Shadow Run?
I wasn't there.
I want everyone. If someone could just put these down, I would be very appreciative of it.
Because after this job, I was going to buy a super platinum dock wagon contact. Not contact, contract.
Yeah, that's probably definitely going to save you from death.
5 times.
Per year.
I think it lasts longer. I don't know.
No, you have to pay $100,000 a year for that, for super platinum.
Oh, okay. That was it. Okay.
There was something else about HTR. I was like, what the fuck is that?
I would just do gold, because either gold or platinum, you still get a resurrection.
Yeah, this gets you 5 in a year.
Oh, that gets you 5, actually? Okay.
Yeah.
I didn't know how many got you.
Everyone but Manga has a second initiative pass.
Well, you're forgetting that my first turn in combat is giving myself 3 more initiative passes. Through magic.
Yeah. And Manga, is it like if you can
see... Since you're the tiniest troll ever, since you're the most baby troll ever, another troll is going to curb stomp you. depending on how augmented he is.
I'm tiny, but I'm dense. That's actually, if you read about the actual subspecies of troll, I'm actually a smaller troll, but my body is actually more than a regular troll's. We're just smaller and dense.
Do you have wired reflexes?
Yeah.
All right, that's why it has it. I thought you accidentally mistaked your Matrix initiative.
Yeah, no. By the way, Super Platinum subscribers are entitled to 5 free resuscitations a year and do not have to pay for HTR services or death compensation.
Ooh, that's actually pretty nice.
I don't know what HTR actually is. Because it's not clear in here. It says what the acronym means, but doesn't, you know, say what it actually means.
Hold on, I'll get Neo-Anarchist Guide to Real Life.
Okay, so
high threat response. That's what that means.
Okay, so we're ending the session here, then. Alright.
In theory.
Alright, I'm just gonna end the recording.